I'm super intrigued. Tesla changed the battery chemistry, the battery packs in the new Model Y is going to Canada. But the thing is, these are the same cars that Tesla send to Australia, to Israel, New Zealand, Singapore, many countries around the world get these cars. Does that mean that if they made these battery pack changes for the cars for Canada, those changes will also apply to everywhere else? Because if they do, this is actually much bigger news than it sounds. If you believe what Elon Musk has said, and a lot of customers, then this change in Canada is a good thing. All Tesla Model Ys that'll be sold in Canada from now on will be from China exclusively. Here is why I actually think that this is a good thing for customers, and why if you've been on the fence about buying a Tesla Model Y, well, this is one reason why I would consider doing it. Hello, my friends. Welcome to the channel. I'm the Electric Viking. Great to see you. Thank you for tuning in. Canadian EV buyers. Obviously, this video is specifically really for you. Tesla is going to import all existing Model Y versions from China to Canada. Tesla, as you probably already know, began shipping the base model, the cheapest version, the Model Y rear-wheel drive, from China not long ago. And it's now added the long range and performance versions. So all three versions now are coming from China. That's according to the Natural Resources Canada listing. So Tesla is right now preparing, and it's about to export Model Y variants made in Gigafactory Shanghai from Shanghai to Canada. So all three variants, which does mean there will be some changes to the battery packs. Now, it's speculated that this information is correct because basically it's listed on the Natural Resources Canada listing discovered by Jay Pelletier on Reddit from Tesla North. The listing details the new Model Y long range, the all-wheel drive variant specifically stands for import. So this is not something confirmed by Tesla themselves. So we don't know, you know, exactly whether or not this is for 100% guaranteed certain, but it appears to me as though it's pretty reliable information. And it's also very logical that Tesla would do this. The 2023 Tesla Model Y long range all-wheel drive will have a range of 497 kilometers. That's 309 miles. That's a little bit less than the current version, but actually it's probably more than it sounds. Why is that? Well, yes, it's true. The current version has 330 miles of range, right? That's 21 miles or more range, 531 kilometers. So that's what? 34 kilometer difference. However, the new version, I believe, will have lithium iron phosphate batteries. That's why the range is shorter, right? Those batteries are less energy dense. As you can see, not by a lot. It's only, 5%? But here's the thing. Tesla tell you to fully charge their lithium iron phosphate battery pack. So they say you should fully charge them once a week. That's what Tesla actually say. In fact, Tesla say you can fully charge them as much as you want. I'm not saying you should do that. I'm not really convinced that's the best strategy. But it is true that it's not going to harm the battery if you do it, you know, once a week. So that means that it's probably in theory longer range, because you're not really meant to fully charge your nickel-based chemistry batteries, which are, you know, the battery packs in most EVs, and the battery packs that you guys used to get in the Model Y long range and the Model 3 long range, same with the performance variants. And you used to get the nickel-based chemistry batteries, which Tesla says, well, you know, you can charge them to 100%, but you could get some battery degradation, possibly faster. That may not be true. I mean, a lot of people have found that it's not necessarily the case anymore, but it's still true that people don't really want to charge above 90% on average. So if you're not charging above 90% and you are charging your lithium ion phosphate battery to 100%, then you're getting 5% more range instead of 5% less. In the real world, this is actually pretty much true. Pretty much plays out this way. Most people with lithium ion phosphate battery packs, they don't care about charging to 100% because of this information, which not only comes from CATL, who make these batteries, but also BYD, who make these batteries as well. They both say, yeah, it's fine, you can charge to 100%. And both of them claim you get about double the amount of charges in their lithium ion phosphate batteries versus what you get in nickel-based chemistry batteries. Now, we haven't seen enough information yet to know how this plays out in 10 years' time. We don't really know. Based on initial testing, it looks like it could be relatively true, but we don't know for sure. We haven't had thousands of EVs that have been around on the roads for 10 years with these newer version lithium ion phosphate batteries, which have much higher energy density than the older version. But I still do think they're a better battery pack for the long run, less stress, more likely not to burn. How many fires have you seen with lithium iron phosphate batteries in them? Very few. Very, very few. Right now, they probably make up about 50% of the EVs manufactured worldwide because manufacturers have moved towards them, in particular in China. However, most of these fires, I'm talking 9 out of 10 that occur in EVs, not that they're common, but they do happen, occur in non-lithium iron phosphate based battery packs. So I think it's actually kind of an upgrade, in fact. Even though the range is slightly slower, in theory, you can see why I think it's actually an improvement. Now, let me know if you agree with that in the comments. In terms of the motor in the long range, it's equipped with a 291 kilowatt motor with a 10 hour recharge time if you charge it on the slow charger at home. But of course, if you want to fast charge it, it'll take around 25 minutes to get from 10 to 80%. Here's the thing. The price of the Model Y long range could become, as a result of this, under $65,000 Canadian dollars. And if it is, then that makes this car significantly cheaper than the current model. What that'll mean is you'll qualify for the discount of $7,000 if you buy an EV in Canada, meaning the car would potentially, say Tesla prices it at $64,900, meaning it comes in at $58,000. For the long range version of the car, with what I think a lot of people will think is a better battery pack. So this is quite a good deal. And I believe the Model Y long range will actually come in at that price. Now, currently, that said, on the Tesla website now, the price is more than that. It's $69,990. But pretty good chance Tesla will lower that price because that's a lot more than the standard version. And it's not really that much better. I mean, the standard version is $59,990. That model comes with around 400 kilometers of range. But I mean, big difference, right? Between the prices here, $10,000 more for the long range version. Is it worth $10,000 more? I don't think it is. And realistically, I think Tesla is smart enough to know that a lot more buyers will buy the car, the long range version, if it's priced at $65,000, because then they'll get the additional $7,000, meaning the car would, in theory, be $12,000 cheaper to them. I think probably within the next 3 or 4 months, Tesla will do that. They just need more stock from China, get more stock to Canada, you know, and then they want to increase that demand. They'll reduce the prices. That's what I'm predicting. Can't say for sure this will happen, but I think it's extremely likely. The other change here is the Model Y Performance. Surprisingly, that one also now comes from China. That now has 459 kilometers of range, so less range. Of course, it's now got, it appears, a lithium iron phosphate battery as well. I haven't seen Tesla do this before. I wasn't aware that the Model Y Performance was manufactured with lithium iron phosphate batteries anywhere. This is a pretty big change here to know that it comes with LFP batteries now. But either way, the Model Y Performance is actually a pretty damn good deal in Canada for $76,000. That equates to a pretty low price in terms of US dollars. That's actually really, really affordable. It's much cheaper than what it is in Australia. So you can see lithium iron phosphate battery packs, I believe, cost Tesla a lot less money than nickel-based chemistries, whether they're 2170s or 4680s. Tesla pays a lot less for an equivalent lithium iron phosphate battery pack, whether that's from CATL or from BYD. And that's just how that all works. Very interesting change though to the Model Y to know it now comes in the performance version with that lithium iron phosphate battery pack. Is this to you? Is this make you more likely to buy it or less likely? By the way, it's really interesting to hear what Elon Musk said. I mean, Elon Musk just said, yeah, you guys in China, you make the best cars. So if you believe him, then actually, now you're getting a better car in Canada than you were before. Let me know your thoughts on this and thank you for watching. Bye-bye.